Guys, so I am here with a demo slash review of the Kat Von D Locket Foundation. I look completely different than I did the other day. I tried to film the review portion of this video just because, I don't know, I tried to film it like a couple of times and it just was like not working out for me. So I decided I'm going to start again fresh today, and so we're here. But other than that, let's go ahead and get on into the review. But how I purchased my Kat Von D foundation was actually as a set with the beauty blender, since I don't have a real, genuine beauty blender. I have a knockoff beauty blender, and I've done a video for it before, so I will link that video down below. They're practically dupes now, in my opinion. I do have a real beauty blender to like test it with and compare it, so if you want me to redo that video, I can definitely do that for you guys, no problem whatsoever. But this is how I purchased mine at Sephora, and this is the Kat Von D and Beauty Blender customizable complexion set, and you pick whatever foundation is your like match, and then it comes with the beauty blender in black. And it also comes with a sample of the Locket Featherweight Primer and the Liquid Blender Cleanser, like a little packet of the Liquid Blender Cleanser in here. So basically, this set retails for $46. The Kat Von D Foundation retails for $35. So you get the Beauty Blender for a few dollars cheaper than you normally would on its own, because I do believe that it does retail for $20 for a Beauty Blender. The actual foundation, this is what it comes in. So if you just want to buy it by itself and you already have a Beauty Blender, just go ahead and pick it up, because you'll save some money. In the long run, you just won't have to like buy something else and it's going to rack up your cost. So this is in the shade Light 44, and on the top, the like sticker is actually more pinky toned, and then the box, sorry, that was my phone, is like yellow based, and it's more of a yellow based foundation. I'm not wearing it today, however, and you can probably see my skin looks really, really crappy. So this foundation comes in a packaging like this. It's basically a plastic cylindrical clear bottle with a pump. It is a hidden pump, which is kind of cool. And I do like the packaging. It is quite bulky, but I like that as you pump it out, the product starts to go up from the bottom and you don't waste any product. So you really are getting every penny out of this product. Because applying it with your beauty blender, I like it that way because it provides a lot of moisture. My finish for the foundation with the beauty blender is a lot more dewy. This is a satin finish foundation. It is 100% full coverage. Especially with the beauty blender, it's still full coverage. It's just like moving around the product and putting it where it needs to go and picking it up, and it's not as sheer as you would think it might be. Like with the beauty blender, it's like literally exactly the same, it's just more dewy. I in the video set my foundation as always with my Airspun powder, and in that video I actually applied it differently with a different type of tool. I didn't use the beauty blender, just strictly because I'm probably going to redo my dupe video and all that jazz with the one I have previously and the real beauty blender now. So I went ahead and I've been testing this brush out for a few, like probably a week now probably, and I'm really starting to enjoy this. And basically I picked this up because I was like, this looks really similar and like density wise as the Artiste brushes. It's not as large as the one that Jaclyn Hill uses, and I'm pretty sure Jaclyn Hill, I don't know, I want to say it's like Oval 8, but it's a really large brush and it basically covers like almost all of your cheek and everything in one go. But this is literally so much similar, and I'm pretty sure those brushes are like $100 a pop or something. They're really expensive. I don't know how expensive they are because I've never bought one. I've only like felt them and saw them, and it just seemed like it would be a dupe. So that's what I used it for. I'm going to be doing a separate video on this particular brush, so for more information, just subscribe and stay tuned for that video. Will probably be coming out in March sometime, I believe. Just so you guys are aware, foundation has not clogged up my pores, and I've actually slept with the foundation on my skin to test and see what will happen if you fall asleep with this makeup on your face. And nothing actually happened. I didn't get any extra acne than before, no like extra texture. And actually when I wake up, this is actually like kind of still on my face, if you will, but it's not like on there like you look like Beyonce. It's on my face, but in patches and all that jazz. So I mean, I wouldn't recommend sleeping in it, but if you do, I would be aware because it is full coverage. But for me, it was okay. But if you have sensitive skin, probably not. As far as wear throughout the day, I would say that this foundation is not a long-wearing foundation. I would say it only lasts for about 6 hours, maybe 8. And I've tried it with primers. I've tried it on its own. I've tried just, like, blotting throughout the day. And it's still, whenever I just start having, like, oil show up on my face, which would be in my T-zone, I start to get these little balls of foundation all over my skin. It's kind of like when you've had a shirt for a really long time and it starts to get bally because it's just getting old. That's literally what my face looks like, an old ratty shirt. And it's kind of weird, so that's just because it starts to get oily. You can wipe them away and stuff, but you'll start to see that the foundation will start to throw or start to show your, like, redness underneath, if you have any anyway, or you'll just start to see your skin underneath the foundation. It's not like breaking apart, but these are just these balls that are like collecting up on my skin, and it's really strange because my mom will be like, it's a piece of fuzz or something, and it's like foundation, and when you get it on your finger, you're like rolling it around. It's not sticking to your skin, but you know it's foundation. It's really, really weird. So I would say this lasts a good 6 hours. You might be pushing it for 8. I definitely wouldn't recommend this if you have dry, flaky skin, just because it is so creamy and thick. If you have very oily skin, it might only last you for 2 to 4 hours, depending on how oily you are. If you're somewhere in a happy medium, I have a very dry nose, I can get dry cheeks. But if I moisturize correctly, and if you moisturize correctly, if you have very dry skin, then this is going to be okay. But I would definitely recommend this for people with normal combo skin that's just slightly oily, because you can get away with 6 hours, and that's quite a long time, but if you work an 8-hour day at work, then it's not. And that's just my personal thoughts. Let's go ahead and get on into the demo for you guys, and I will meet you back. Really great on the skin, and I do have to say it is because of these two products that I've been using to moisturize my skin. So first off, I use the e.l.f. soothing serum all over the face, up under the eyes, around the nose, everywhere. And it's a really great moisturizing, soothing serum for the skin, literally. It really absorbs into my skin quickly, and it makes you think that you're not hydrated, but you are. Maybe if you're super dry, you won't be, but it does take quite a lot of product to, like, get your whole face covered, but it's a great product. And then, secondly, I use the e.l.f. Illuminating Eye Cream, and I use this up under my eyes as well as around, like, the crevices of my nose, like, right here, these folds, because that's where I get really, really dry. It's very flaky, and these products work well. At the time when I was using this and did this video, the demo part, I was actually out of my regular moisturizer. I repurchased it, and it does the same exact thing. But if you're looking for something because you have dry, flaky skin, these two products are going to be your miracle workers. So those are my thoughts for the Kat Von D Locket Foundation. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a huge thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if you are going to purchase this foundation or purchase the skincare items. I just wanted to let you know that I will be doing a review of those skincare items, and you will see that after this video, of course. But I would just go in depth more on those products and how they work for me and how I like them and things like that in that video. So subscribe and stay tuned for that video in the next coming weeks. As well as the Artiste dupe brush video. That should be coming shortly after this video as well, maybe even next week. Again, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys!